Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture series of Computer Organization and Architecture. Today's topic is Register Transfer Language, that is RTL. So in this video, I will tell you about the register and then I will discuss about Register Transfer Language. Let us begin. First, let us understand what is register, what is the use of register. So register, it is a very fast computer memory which is used to store data or instructions in execution. Means register is a kind of thing wherever you would like to write in some information at the designated place. So whenever required, you can get the information also. So register is a kind of memory. And when you have to construct a register, definitely there must be some elements. So flip-flops are used for the register. So a register, it is a group of flip-flops, and each and every flip-flop is capable to store one bit of the information. So if suppose you are having 10 bits of information, so 10 flip-flops are required, right? Similarly, over here I have written a generalized term. N-bit register has a group of n flip-flops and it is capable of storing n bits of binary information. So a register, it consists of a group of flip-flops and the gates, right? The use of flip-flop is to store or to hold the binary information, while gates are used to control how and when new information is transferred into a register. There are various types of registers are available in market for the commercial purpose, and you can give a simplest example of the register, the very basic example, which consists of only flip-flops. There is no external gate. That is the simple example of the register. Now, let's talk about some of the commonly used registers. One is the accumulator. Accumulator is the most common register. Whenever you are going to study further, you are going to find out that this unit is available over here, where all the required operation needs to be performed. Even the result is also being stored over here. So it is used to store the data taken out from the memory. There are some general purpose registers. General purpose registers are used to store the data at intermediate stages during the program execution, and it can be accessed via assembly programming. What do you mean by intermediate results? Suppose you are adding two numbers or you are multiplying two numbers. So you are doing what? You are adding bit by bit or you are multiplying bit by bit. So those intermediate results can be stored in the general purpose registers. Next, let us talk about some special purpose registers. So special purpose registers, they are for computer system only. Users do not have any access to these registers. Some of the special purpose registers I have listed out over here, and you can see in this particular diagram, the connection between the processor and the main memory is being shown over here. There is a MAR. MAR is memory address register. So this memory address register, it holds the address for memory unit. While memory data register, it stores instruction and data which is received from the memory and sent from the memory. There is a program counter, it is also a register. It points out the next instruction which is to be executed. If one instruction is being executed and after the completion of first, it will increment by one and will point out the next instruction. Next register is IR, which is the instruction register, and it holds the instruction which is to be executed. And here also you can observe general purpose registers where the information can be stored at the intermediate stages. You can see N general purpose registers starting from R0 to Rn-1. So this is how you can explain about the register. Now let's talk about register transfer language. What is register transfer language? So the symbolic notation which is used to describe the micro operation transfer among register is known as a register transfer language. It means what? It is a symbolic notation, right? Let me tell you something more. If we talk about the sequence of a micro operation in a digital computer, which can be explained just by describing every operation in the form of the words, right? If a word is 16-bit register, if a word is 16-bit register, then what will happen? This method is actually not used because it is very much time-consuming process, because 16-bit identification, writing, reading, it is very much time consuming. It means we can use certain symbols to describe this particular sequence, right, of transfer between the registers and micro operations, which are associated with the register transfer, and that is done by using register transfer language. And with the help of register transfer language, we can list micro operation sequence among the registers of digital computer system. It means here comes a term, register transfer. So how you can define this particular term? Register transfer means availability of hardware logic circuit that can perform some micro operation and transfer the result of operation to another register or to some specified register. This is what the register transfer is. Suppose you are having two registers R1 and R2. You would like to transfer the content of register R1 into R2. That is what the register transfer. And here in the case of RTL, which is the register transfer language, you are finding a term language. So this particular word language that is borrowed from the programmers. Programmers use frequently this particular term in their programming languages. So this particular word is being borrowed from there. So now you can say that this programming language, it is a procedure for writing symbols to specify a given computational process, right? This is how you can explain. Directly you can transfer the information from one register to the another, or sometimes you may apply some control signals, just like you are applying if else condition while doing the programming in C. You can apply the same thing over here. Condition, if this condition fulfills, then only the content of one register will be transferred into the another one. This is how you can explain it. I will discuss about the register transfer in the next video in detail. Here I am giving you a very brief about that. So the basic features of register transfer languages are, it is capable for micro operations, it is a symbolic language, and it is convenient tool for describing the internal organizations of a digital computer. And RTL can also be used to facilitate the design process of the digital system. So this is how you can explain about the register transfer language. Thank you so much for watching this video.